In order to boost tourism revenue and grow the economy, the country has for long needed billions of shillings to connect internet and other telecommunication networks at the tourism sites. Today, the State Minister for ICT and National Guidance, Godfrey Kabianga, has confirmed that the ministry has received new funding from Exim Bank, which is close to $200 million, to extend the internet to national parks and underserved areas in the country.
Determined to have internet even in the remote areas, because under PDM, we want to have internet at every parish. Since the parish development model is systems driven, and we have started working on this. We already have a loan from World Bank to take internet to every parish, but we have also acquired a loan from Exim Bank, which is going to build another 700 and over 700 kilometers of the national backbone. But we strongly believe in the next 3 to 4 years we should have covered the whole country.
Uganda has been facing a huge challenge at some of its national parks, where the tourists cannot keep in touch with their families due to lack of internet connectivity. Over the past 3 decades, the internet has become an integral part of our daily life. Technology transformed the way people communicate. Minister Kabianga reiterated that concerted efforts to expand internet access is a unique opportunity to unlock immense potential for growth and development of a country. Besides making the internet affordable, much focus is to also be put on making smartphones affordable and easily accessible, so that at least every Ugandan is connected to the 3G network.
Used also as cheap as possible, to ensure they are also affordable, because there are some people in the rural areas who are still using 2G phones, and 2G phones cannot access internet. We want all Ugandans to upgrade to 3G so that they can access internet, and therefore they can access information.
The development comes at a time when the world is celebrating the International Day for Universal Access to Information, which happens on every 28th of September. Uganda will hold its celebrations tomorrow at the Uganda Institute of Technology at Nakawa in Kampala. Officials from the African Freedom Information Center want the government to use this day to remove all the obstacles in accessing information, but most importantly, remove the ban on Facebook.
Use the cost of internet services to make them more accessible. If you can look at the price of internet in 2013, it was about $1,200 per megabyte per second. But in 2014, it reduced to around $300 per megabyte per second. And today, in 2017, it had gone to around $190 per megabyte per second. And then it went on reducing till it reached $70 per megabyte per second. But currently, we are at $35 per megabyte per second as government.
Story compiled by Jared Namoya and Charity Marion for the news.